witness the zombie did call. True pain and suffering he brought to them all. Away ran the children to hide in their beds, for fear that the devil would chop off their heads.
Hey, this is Chris coming at you again from my channel, I Am Toys. This is going to be a review of Wondus Customs' Jason Goes to Hell concept piece. I've kind of been on a hiatus for a little while as far as figure reviews. Recently moved out of our residence again. Officially moved twice in the last year, which has been a blast, let me tell you. You can't hear the sarcasm in my voice. It's there. But yeah, we just recently moved. We were in an apartment, kind of sucked. Everyone was on top of each other, so we decided to just get into a house now. So I got most of my shit up. Kind of ready to start doing reviews again. Those of you know, I did get a shipment in of like four different pieces from ones. This was one of them. I saw a variation of this concept piece over the last year or so, and I wanted him to do one for me. So I reached out to him and I asked for a few different tweaks to it, you know, the arm and such. And he knocked it out of the park, man. He really did. It's probably the best Jason Goes to Hell concept piece I've ever seen in my entire life. Those of you who have seen my collection probably think that I am the biggest Jason or Myers fan on the planet, but I am actually not. I am actually probably one of the biggest Freddy Krueger fans. But there just isn't a lot out there as far as the mainstream market for Freddy Krueger figures. They're kind of subpar at the 1/6 scale, but I do finally have a couple that are excellent. I'm going to be doing some reviews of those too at some point. So let's get into this one, and make sure you hit that 4K option in the YouTube browser itself, so that way you get this video in all its glory. So I'll zoom in on this thing and pan it and give you guys some looks and run my mouth a little bit. All right, so here's some close-ups of it, you know, of the sculpt. As you can see, in true traditional ones custom style, he did absolutely incredible work on the sculpt and on the details, the clothes, man, you know, you name it. Looks fantastic. And again, like I said, you'll probably see some variations of this out somewhere, but this one is definitely a little different. The mask is also removable. Of course, I'll probably show you that too as well. Probably, of course. But like I said, man, this thing's fantastic. A lot of people didn't like Jason Goes to Hell because didn't really have Jason in it for a lot of the film. But I thoroughly enjoyed all of these films for what they were worth. I mean, Part 7 is my favorite, 100%, but I enjoyed Jason Goes to Hell solely because of the look. And this mask is a little bigger than how it looks in the film. The film's probably a little bit smaller on the head, but I actually liked that he made it bigger. That was probably one of my gripes. Even though I liked the look of Jason in that film, that was probably one of the gripes that I had. As far as how it looked, I probably would have made the mask, you know, a little bit bigger. So it was nice that he actually did that. So one's actually took what I didn't like, and not even that I asked for it, and already made it better. And who knows, maybe he did that on purpose. I didn't talk to him about it. But if he did, maybe that was one of his dislikes about what the mask looked like, maybe a little too small. So I like that it's kind of increased in size. And the reason why I asked for the arm is, you know, this look also reminded me, when I saw the original concept that he did, reminded me of Jason X too as well, and how he looked. And I liked the part of the film, and similar in Jason Goes to Hell too, where he's blown apart, but I liked in Jason X where he was kind of having his body parts blown off, his leg, his arm, and he's kind of standing there with, you know, with his arm not attached, and I thought that was pretty cool. So I wanted the severed arm and to be able to reattach it. And how ones did that was actually pretty ingenious. It's pretty cool, and you probably don't notice it right now, but I'll show you as when I rotate the figure around and show you those looks, kind of what he did. It's kind of ingenious. I like it because you don't even really notice it. but it's killer. And this thing is a beast, man. Like I said, best Jason Goes to Hell concept piece I've ever seen. I think it's amazing. Incredible work. And you get that arm, obviously. That arm kind of reattaches. You know, as I said, I'll kind of give it away once I rotate the figure around. But this thing is immaculate, man. Immaculate work. And I wouldn't expect nothing less, you know, from ones. The way he's able to pump out four figures for me in a relatively great, awesome period of time. And we had a deal amongst ourselves. So I was able to get these a little faster. Some of these he was already kind of working on. So when I asked for these, it was, you know, he kind of works on a lot of things all at the same time. So I lucked out that some of the things that I was requesting, he was kind of already halfway through or already in the process of making. So it's nice that I was able to get it in a fast time, because I know some people are waiting for figures for a long ass time from one. So, but it's worth it, folks. It's worth the damn wait. When you get these things in hand, they're absolutely incredible. So let me spin this sucker around and I'll allow it to rotate after this cutaway, and it'll run my mouth a little bit longer. All right, so I got this thing rotating, and as you can see, you know, severed arm. So as this thing rotates, wait until you see what ones did to pull this off. Oh, there it is. So as you can see, the arm can actually bend back towards the back, which isn't something miraculous, but the fact that the clothes were tailored, you know, enough to be able to hide that and pull that off is fantastic. And then as you can see, you got this side of the shoulder coming around where it looks severed. And then as it rotates around, it almost blends right back in. You can't even tell, man. It's awesome. Dude, I texted him and I was like, yo, man. I was like, that's awesome. He had actually forgot what that I'd requested for the modified arm, so he had to adjust the body a little bit. But it's fantastic. So that piece, that severed piece that you see on the side of the shoulder that's going to swing around in a second, is actually magnetized. So there's a magnet in the shoulder, and you basically just attach it right there. You bend the arm back, and you attach it to the shoulder right at the top. And that's that, man. And he pulled it off. It's fucking cool as shit. And as my man Terrell likes to say over at his channel, Anomaly, his Anomaly channel, he's got some numbers after it too, and I don't want to try to butcher what they are because I don't know what the hell they are. But Terrell, like he likes to say, you know, there's some exposure points. I like that term. It's a good description of exactly what you see, you know, skin breaking through, you know, whether it's the rib cage or the bones in his back. And as you can see from this side, when he pans back around, you can see the exposure points of the spine, you know, right there as well, which is really cool. Some straps on his wrist too as well, almost like a strap down mental patient kind of stuff. Again, some people look at this and be like, oh, that's not accurate to the film. It's not supposed to be. It is a concept piece, and it's fantastic. So let me take the mask off and show you his ugly mug underneath of that. But actually, as it spins around, I'm going to show you one more thing, which is pretty cool. You got to be careful with the mask, putting it on, so one strap kind of goes over the hair and another one kind of goes underneath, so it kind of overlays. But there's these little tiny magnets in the back that keep the back together, and they're all pinpoint perfect kind of where they need to be, and they all stay in place, as you can see. So let me get that mask off, show you the face, and we'll close this video out. All right, and last but not least, you know, close out with a look at that face. Like I said, it's a killer sculpt, man. One's really kills the details, man. When he gets in there, man, it's fantastic. Like we saw, he doesn't look, you know, looks more like a zombie, you know, when you take off, you know, Jason's mask. He gives off more of a zombie vibe, and there's been a whole debate, you know, over the years, as Jason or Friday the 13th fans, you know, is Jason technically a zombie? But I don't know. I don't like referring to him as a zombie. I feel like that takes away a lot of the supernatural element. Are zombies technically supernatural? It depends what kind of movie you watch. You know, some of it's due to chemicals, some of it's due to religious stuff. Supernatural, maybe. They are dead walking, I guess. They're living dead walking on Earth, so I guess there is a supernatural element to it. But, I prefer to view Jason as a little more higher, we'll say, on an elevated level, more up on the hierarchy than that. He's definitely more menacing with the mask on for sure, but some people, like to display without it as well. It's because it gives you a whole nother dynamic. So, all right, guys, let's look at this. And then for those of you folks asking for a collection update, eventually I am going to do one. Once I settle in a little bit more, I start catching up on a few of these horror figure reviews. And then I'll... like I said, I'll do one, and I'll update you guys. So for now, that's it for this. Next review, I'm actually going to film another one right after this, and that's going to be Beto's Long Arm Freddy that I recently picked up, which is also fantastic. So, all right, guys, like, subscribe, hit me on Instagram, same handle as well, and feel free to comment. I'm somewhat good at getting back to people on YouTube, but sometimes not, so... It is what it is. All right, guys. Deuces.